Greetings to all and welcome to the session 3 of Unit 3 Reciprocating Machines. For the course Machine Tool Technology, course code is 15ME43T. Myself Mohammed Imran, lecturer, Government Polytechnic, Harwar. Today's session we are discussing about cutting speed, feed, depth of cut of shaper, working of shaper machine. The cutting speed in a shaper is defined as the amount of the rate at which the material metal is removed from the workpiece by the cutting tool. It is expressed in meter per minute, that is how much meter of material is removed in 1 minute by the shaper. As you know, the shaper is intended to produce the to machine a flat surface. If a rectangular block is there, so somewhat length, suppose 1 meter length is there, in 1 minute how much material is removed by the shaper is known as cutting speed. How much meter of metal is removed in 1 minute is defined by the cutting speed. The cutting speed is given by the formula n into l multiplied by 1 plus m divided by 1000 meter per minute, where s is length of cutting stroke divided by length of time required by the cutting stroke. S is defined as length of cutting stroke divided by time required by the cutting stroke. So S is nothing but cutting speed here. So here L indicates the length of stroke in millimeter. Length of stroke in millimeter. Suppose the ram is having a particular length of stroke. So how much the ram will move in a cutting stroke is known as length of stroke. N equals to number of double stroke of the ram. Number of double stroke means one is forward stroke and on this return stroke. How many strokes are made to complete one component is known as n. It is multiplied by total cutting speed in order to get the machining time. Here m equals to ratio of between cutting stroke to the return stroke. M is the ratio of cutting stroke to the return stroke. There will be a ratio between cutting stroke to the return stroke, because cutting stroke and return stroke are not same in case of shaper. Always the cutting stroke is takes much time compared to return stroke, which is quick return. So S is cutting speed in meter per minute. So depth of cut, it is the thickness of the metal removed in one cut. Depth of cut is what? It is the thickness of the metal is removed from in one cut. It is the perpendicular distance measured between the machine surface. It is the perpendicular distance measured between the machine surface and non-machined surface. It is expressed in millimeter. So it is the thickness of the material removed from the workpiece. It is nothing but the perpendicular distance from the machine surface to the unmachined surface. So it is the thickness, that nothing but thickness expressed in millimeter. So feed, it is the relative movement of the tool or work perpendicular to the axis of reciprocating of the ram. If the ram reciprocate in a longitudinal direction, then perpendicular to that direction we feed will be given. So perpendicular to the direction what is the feed is given is known as feed. What is the distance, the crosswise movement of the tool perpendicular to the reciprocation of the ram is known as feed. It is the relative movement of the tool or work perpendicular to the axis of the reciprocating of the ram for double stroke, not for cutting stroke, for double stroke, including the return stroke you have to calculate. It is expressed in millimeter. The selection of feed is depends upon the kind of metal, type of job. It is relative movement of the tool and the work in the direction perpendicular to the movement of the ram. So the feed depends upon the which kind of material we are using for machining, and also the kind of operation required, depending upon the material used for workpiece and depending upon the material of workpiece and depending upon the operation performed, the feed may vary. It is not same for all the operations. Next, the machining time, the calculation of machining time. So it is the time required to machine or complete the one job, or it is the total time taken to complete one cut. It is the time required to complete the job, or it is the total time taken to complete one cut. It is given by the formula T equals to L into B 1 plus M divided by 1000 S into F, where L is the length of job measured in millimeter, length of the job including approach and overrun. So approach and overrun means if a component is of 1000 millimeter, the length of probe will not be 1000 millimeter. So it will be in the work, the tool must start some before the start of the workpiece, and it will move somewhat extra moment after the completion of job. That means 1000 mm workpiece is there, means 20 mm extra you have to start from 20 mm extra below the 20 mm below the workpiece start workpiece starting point, you have to take 20 mm below, that is approach. And after the completion of the length of the workpiece, then you have to overrun for a length of 20 mm, that is known as overrun. So total 20 plus 20, 1000 plus 40 with the total length of the probe, total length of probe, that will be considered in L. B is the breadth of the job, including the side clearance for machining. For F is the speed in millimeter, S is the cutting speed in meter per minute. So let us discuss a simple problem in the calculation of machining time. So the problem is given as, find the time required on shaper to machine 600 into 1200 millimeter rectangular surface. It is a rectangular surface of right one shape here. Like this. So this is 600 mm width and 1200 mm length. Job is has to be cut here. 1200 mm job. If the cutting speed is 15 meter per minute, the cutting speed is given as 15 meter per minute. The ratio of return stroke to the cutting stroke is 2:3. The return stroke is 2 times means the cutting stroke takes 3 times. So it is the ratio. The clearance at each end is 25 mm, the clearance. So if the length of the job is 600 along the length, 25 mm along the length and 15 mm on width. So clearance is given as 25 mm each on lengthwise and 15 mm on widthwise. That means what? If the component is of 1200 mm this length, the tool has to start not from this exact this point. The tool has to take a clearance of 25 mm here, and it has to overrun for a length of 25 mm here for clearance. It should not stop here only exactly. It requires some extra movement. That is, it is given as 25 mm here on the lengthwise. It is the length, 1200 mm we are taking it as length, and 600 mm it is width. In widthwise, we have to take a clearance of 15 mm, that means 15 mm extra here, 15 mm extra here. That means the tool has to start somewhere here, that is 25 mm extra and 15 mm extra clearance from here. The tool has to start from here, it will start reciprocating like this. After the one complete stroke, one complete stroke means it has to move forward, and it has to move forward for a 25 mm extra length, and then it has to come backward. So after that, the feed will be given. The feed in the the cross feed is 2 mm per stroke. The cross feed is 2 mm stroke per finish cut. For finish cut, for rough cut, and for finish cut it is 1 mm. So after the, it is first time we have to give rough cut, so that means after completion of one stroke, the tool will move 2 mm here like this, 2 mm forward, and then again it will perform the forward and return stroke. After that again 2 mm it will move, again it will perform the forward and return stroke, again you have to move 2 mm, like this it has to do continuously after completion of one cut up to here, 25 mm extra clearance. So after that you have to finish, in the finish cut it has to give 1 mm cut, so that means here after completion of one forward and return stroke, so the feed has to move, the tool has to move 1 mm in crosswise direction, 1 mm in crosswise direction, then again you have to perform the cutting operation like this it has to perform. So we have to calculate the total time required for machining. So two cuts are required, one roughing cut with a cross feed of 2 mm per stroke and one finish cut with a feed of 1 mm per stroke. So cross feed is 2 mm per stroke and cross feed for finish cut is 1 mm per stroke. The length of stroke equals to length of plate plus the clearance on both sides. The length of plate is 1200 and the clearance on both sides, this side and this side, 2 into 25 mm. Lengthwise it is given as 25 mm. So that will become 1215 mm. And the cross travel of the table W equals to width of the jaw plus clearance on both sides. So width of the jaw is 600 mm and the clearance is this side and this side 15 mm, 2 into 15 that is 30. So total length of stroke on width wise is 630 mm. It has to clear a width of 630 mm and the length of 1250 mm. The ratio is 0.67, 2 by 3 is 0.67 m. The ratio m is the ratio of cutting stroke to the return stroke. Return stroke to the cutting stroke. The ratio of return stroke to the cutting stroke. Return stroke is always lesser than the cutting stroke. So 0.67. You can see the solution here. So time for complete for one stroke is given by L plus L into 1 plus M divided by 1000 into V, where V is the cutting speed, L is the length of stroke, M is the cutting ratio. So L is we have calculated as 1250 mm, 1 is constant and plus M ratio. This is the ratio of return stroke to the cutting stroke is 0.67 mm divided by 1000 is constant, V is cutting speed in meter per minute, it is given in the problem 15 meter per minute. So time for one complete stroke is 14.14 minutes. That means to come here, to reach here to here one time, it requires 0.14 minutes. But it is not the total machining time because it has to come here, it has to cover full this length for one time for rough cut, another time for finish cut. So that we have to calculate. So number of stroke for roughing equals to, we have 630 mm it has to be covered. So we have to cover the length of 630 mm. So in each time the tool will move at a distance of 2 mm. 2 mm each side. 2 mm for roughing, the tool has to move 2 mm crosswise. So what first time it will take 14 minutes to come here like this. Then for roughing, the 2 mm per tool is the feed will be given as 2 mm. So like this, again it will take 14.14 minutes and will come like this. Again speed will be given as 2 mm for roughing. So to cover this 630 mm by crosswise, how much time, how much stroke is required, we calculate. The total width is 630. So in each cut it will cover 2 mm. So 2 mm means for covering 630 mm, it will take 2 days, 630 divided by 2. That is 315 stroke. Why? Because I will tell you. So first time it will take 0.14 minute. Again 2 mm is covered now. 0.14 minute. Again 2 mm covered. So 630 means for if it is moving at a speed of 1 mm, then it has to move 630 stroke. But it is moving with a 2 mm crosswise. So it will require 630 divided by 2. That is 315 stroke. So this is for rough stroke, it requires 315 stroke, whereas for finished turning, the crosswise speed is only 1 mm. That means in each stroke, it has, after the completion of each stroke, it has to move 1 mm. So So the total length it has to cover in width wise is 630. So it will be required 630 divided by 1, 630 stroke. So total stroke required is 630 for finish and 315 for rough turning. Total stroke is 945 stroke. So machining time for one stroke is 0.14 minutes. So for total 945 stroke, 945 into 14 is 132 minutes. So the time required for the completion of this component is 132 minutes. So you must know how to calculate the machining time. Next, the working of shaper machine. At the first step, the job or workpiece is set on the working table. Job is set on the table which is fixed, or the table is having T slot with the help of this bolts and nuts. The workpiece is clamped into that table. T bolts are provided in the table, and the workpiece is clamped onto that table. And also, in some cases, bench vices are placed on the table, which can hold the workpiece. One of its jaws is movable. You have seen this jaws in these vices in workshop. The cutting tool is mounted on the tool post. The cutting tool is mounted on the tool post, which is connected to the ram. So the ram reciprocates carrying the tool post. The cutting tool is used in the shaper is single point cutting tool. Now the motor is started, and the motor is used to create the reciprocating motion of the ram by quick return mechanism. It is also known as crank and lever mechanism. And the ram reciprocates. Tool post and the cutting tool mounted on the ram is also reciprocates. The table which can be given upward and downward movement according to the requirement of the workpiece. As the cutting tool reciprocates, the tool comes in contact with the metal and removes the unwanted metal from it. The metal is removed either in forward stroke or backward stroke, and no metal is cut during other stroke. And the stroke is known as idle stroke. The cutting stroke takes place in shaper in only forward stroke. Only in one stroke, the forward stroke or return stroke. In one stroke, the cutting action takes place, usually in forward stroke. If the cutting takes place in forward stroke and the return stroke is idle, if the cutting takes place in the return stroke, then the forward stroke is idle. Whichever stroke is idle, it has to come quickly. It has to achieve quick return. That's why they are using quick return motion mechanism for idle stroke. The cutting stroke is carried out at low speed, and the return stroke is carried out at high speed. The clapper box is used to create the clearance between the tool and the workpiece. The clapper box is used to create the clearance between the tool and the workpiece in the idle stroke. That means in the idle stroke, the tool should not touch the workpiece, otherwise it will damage the workpiece. So during the return stroke, since we have touched the tool to the workpiece, there is a possibility of again the tool will touch the workpiece during the return stroke. To avoid that, the clapper box is provided that will create a gap between workpiece and the tool during the idle stroke. Thank you for watching this session.